and tape it open like most of the teams have been doing.
Well, you know, I mean, if it works for you and you can clip it, then you clip it. I mean, that's how it's supposed to be designed, right? You know? You're not supposed to have to tape your carabiners open. That sounded good. Yeah, very nice.
Really smooth.
Very nice control on that. Just to be sure, huh?
Really got that one.
That's turning it. Not a clip, it's just a... Oh, okay. Well, I guess it's off now. Well, that'll make turning the fuel easier. You just won't be able to... I'd like to see him put that back on. Yep. That's one way to do it. Well, he's watering my can. Oh,
sorry about that.
That's fine. He doesn't have depth perception. He doesn't know where the water's pouring.
Oh, it's slipping.
Yeah. Oh, wrong way. Maybe a splash by accident.
We're gonna have to put fresh water in that one.
Yeah, we're gonna have to refill.
Did it flip? Oh, you're supposed to see the screen as well, right?
Yeah, you're supposed to take a screenshot. He was told that, right?
Yeah.
He did then. But he might not know that. Not in the first try, but definitely that time. But yeah, it's one of those things, like, you know, when you're looking at it from one camera from the front, you can't tell that you've actually pushed it.
No depth perception.
Right, no depth perception. No feedback on force. It's one of those things that's so easy for you to do, but so hard for a rover. At least so far. Maybe you guys can fix that next year.
Trying to actually.
It can get that off of straight GPS?
I think not.
And you got something else on it. You got a digital compass or something.
It should be working. We have a magnetometer as well.
Oh, okay.